Anyways. We got a match. We got some gaming ahead of us.
Match. Yeah, it's crazy. I was hearing Vivi and Nixie talk earlier today. They were talking about playing each other, like what options you find like each other do on ledge. And like Vivi was saying, when ledge trapping Nixie, he always just waits for one like crazy option to happen. That's what he said.
Eventually.
Yeah.
He's like a loose cannon. You know he wants to do something little, like pretty funny to you. So you just gotta sit there, wait, plant your feet, let it happen. So they're feeling each other out, you know, just trying to space themselves really safely. Nick is already trying to cheat. Lots of up smashes coming out.
And that's honestly smart. You want to cheat, because if you don't cheat against Lucario and you let Lucario get Aura, you know, it's a whole different story. And that up smash, what a good read right there on the momentum from Vivi. You can close out the stock right here. It'd be so huge.
That was so good. Nixie tried to make the most like out of the fact that he's that much of a fast follower, that if he didn't even connect that up air, he tried to go through the neutral air. He had the right idea. I think Nick was just a little bit too slow in that moment.
Another big thing we saw from Nixie right here, the side B has armor, so Nixie totally just side beat into the Aura Sphere charge, not caring at all. That was so important, but look at this.
I love that up B. That up B was so
that
funny.
That up B was really funny, yeah. Oh, I think that was a pretty free down tilt right there, but Vivi, it will make it back, and this is so terrifying. You just don't want to get hit once right here, because it can totally just make Vivi's lead extend.
That up B is still not going to kill quite yet, and this is exactly where Vivi wants to be. He plays with pressure in his veins, but then just goes for an immediate get-up attack, and that's Nixie's ledge trap flowchart. He lets his muscle memory, he lets his reactions take over for him. He knows where to sit and sit in shield. All that he needs to do is press up B. Is it going to be reverse up B to cover goal, or is it going to be just up B in place to be able to cover get-up attack, jumps, and neutral get-up? You need to mix up your timings. You've got to know that situation.
Again, that right here, Nixie has not been able to really get a hit on Vivi yet. Never mind. I'm sorry, Nixie.
Sorry, buddy. We didn't beat that one. Aw, that is such a scary setup, too.
Yeah.
Because if you, like, air dodge there, and Nixie knows that you're going to air dodge, he's just going to wait and get a knee catch and get air dodge. It's like a bit of a pseudo 50-50.
I feel like Vivi having, like, a lead in these situations is so much less menacing than Nixie having a lead, you know, because then Vivi has Aura and it can go either way. Right here, I feel like Nixie's not that worried because Vivi has to get, like, a pretty hard read to kill right now.
That was so good! And then just goes for the down smash out of shield, just recognizing how negative that is. That is Falcon Kick. You can release it and press Lucario down smash, so
yeah.
You can't just hit him. You gotta kill him.
Honestly, I feel like Nixie right here is going to be going for, like, the confirms, you know, the Nair 1 knees or something. He doesn't want to, like, get a straight hit on Vivi right now and let Vivi get bigger Aura. He just wants to close it out, and I think that was it.
That up tilt seemed like a missing move. Maybe an up smash he
but it wasn't gonna
maybe an up air?
I don't know. We'll have to ask.
Yeah, we'll just, after this game, we're just going to go up, hey, what was that? What do you mean by this? Goes for the double jump up air, but that's not going to kill. The second one definitely will. At that point, also, it's Lucario. If you air dodge, Nixie has enough time just to track and get another up air out. So, a bit of a nasty place to be in. This is still anybody's game.
Yeah, pretty much the only thing that could have punished Nixie for that was, like, a counter, which would have killed. So, you know,
yep.
Maybe in the back of Vivi's mind is a potential option, but...
That was so scary, he almost found that stomp, and now all of a sudden the percents are looking mighty even. Vivi just backing off a little bit, just trying to find a little bit of space for himself. Oh. Does not find the stomp knee. Nick.
I think Nick thought he had to double jump to hit that, but I believe that was just a normal full hop knee.
The aggression of this man. He just double jumps at you from center stage. What is he on?
Oh. Oh, Vivi!
Lamau.
Going with Nixie. They both rolled. Vivi knew that Nixie would be panicking shield, probably trying to fish for like an uppy ass shield or something. Beautiful. And that's that.
That's it. Vivi's execution.
He doesn't miss those.
Looking like a guillotine the way that he has that execution right now. I've been thinking about that line.
Yeah, that one was years in the making right there. I'm proud of you, though.
Yeah.
And yeah, Vivi saw it against number.
Very class conscious.
Zamba.
Yeah. That was so good. Like, again, like, Aura Sphere is such, like, a non-committal way to do it. And he did, like, a B-reverse Aura Sphere in place just to be able to get that out. No, lovely stuff.
He definitely, like, had that exact confirm in mind right there. Like, he knew when whiff punishing, It covers spot dodge too.
Spot dodge, if it hits shield, it's like, hey,
yeah,
this is safe.
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
I'm still charging this up. It's like a machine gun.
You wanna roll? Oh, I'm gonna then neutral B, or then fire the aura spear and punch your roll.
It's just like constant drrr on your shield too, so Nick was basically dead. He used Gonski's. Okay, game two, Smashville. Keep it in a little bit smaller. Lucario has a lot less space to run away. And Falcon's follow-ups on this stage, especially with Stomp, because of how much space like Stomp covers on Plats, is, whoa, buddy, menacing.
And Nixie, I feel like nothing can deter this man. Nothing will stop him from holding forward. Nothing will stop him from trying to mix up a bunch. And it's really just a matter of how well you can punish these landings. I feel like that's the whole name of the game against Nixie, is how well you know when he's going to land. We saw Numbers do a really good job of it and narrowly lose. See if Vivi can close this out.
It's also knowing like how he's going to cheat. It's like knowing when he wants his stomp knee. It's knowing like when he wants his funny little up smashes on the platforms. You know, if you can get away from that, you're not losing. You suck super early against Nick. But now Nick tries to go for the nearly one. Not really sure like why it sent so far out that time, but wow.
Falcon, weight coming into effect right there. Pretty heavy character. And yeah, that's why I kind of remember in the conversation Vivi was having, he said he just waits for Nixie to do something nutty and then punches after, you know, and that's so important.
Like, was that intentional?
He was shaking his head. I don't think so, but I want to believe.
I want to believe too. It would have been so funny.
It would have been the stupidest intention ever. Like, there's no world in it, but it is funny.
Like, he gave like a little smile after.
Yeah.
I love Nixie's mentality too.
Oh, yeah.
He's just like, something like unintentional happens or he hits some like nonsense, he just laughs about it. Because that's what this game is. It's funny. If you get upset about it, your mentality just goes down the drain and you're gone. So
true.
It's on point. His mental's on point.
And you gotta be, I feel like, with Falcon, have a really good mental, because you can, like, get really, like, you know, comboed to hell, you can get gimped, you know.
Yeah.
You gotta be able to just shake it off, because you know, as a character, as a character, you can be down two stocks against Vivi, but also as a character, you can make it back at any moment. Nixie's punish game is amazing right here, so, like, you really can't count Vivi out, or Nixie out, but it's looking really rough.
I don't want to jinx anything, but it, like, that game three that we really wanted like might look like it's not going to happen. So right now he's in a really good position to find that up tilt. That dash attack surprisingly does not kill. It was a late hit instead of the early hit.
What?
Why did he go like that?
So Lucario can control the direction you go from up B. It's based on what direction Lucario holds. So Vivi was holding left. Wow, got that hit happened.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
That is so cool.
That's a little fun fact. Tell your parents. Tell your grandkids.
Tell your parents. Tell your kids. Tell everybody. That's interesting. Like holding back intentionally at like the last possible second of
it. Yeah, and it hits them the way you're holding.
Interesting. So it's not even like the way that you're holding. It's like not even the direction you're going. It's where you're holding.
Where you're holding, yeah. So you could be going to the right and be flying to the left.
Oh, you could cheat.
Yeah. Almost did right there.
Speaking of cheating, Nick finding an amazing tech chase with the stomp thing, but a little bit too low for sense to find like a knee or anything else out of it. Right now, just playing with so much momentum, Vivi just needs a way to be able to slow this down.
Yeah, I feel like Nixie gets a stock right here. Like, he could so easily run to get out of hand.
And right now, he's just playing with confidence. He's playing with momentum right now. Finds a really big jab there. And now, Vivi, I like the down air just to stall for a little bit longer.
Yeah, that's the thing about this matchup. I feel like Vivi has not gotten killed off stage like once, as far as I can recall. Like, Lucario has such an ability to just wait until like he feels safe and then up B.
That was so smart.
Falcon is so heavy.
Forced out the double jump and he just air dodge right back into the aura sphere. I like that bit of damage control. That up B does not kill yet either.
If he died to that there, that would have been a sad way to end this. This is so scary, though. Like,
yeah.
It's like you kind of feel like you have to drop down with that aura sphere there, but then once you drop down, moving, what does Nixie do against that aura sphere? So it'll cover your re-grab. It'll cover, like, any ledge option, really.
You need to really appreciate how bad this is. First of all, look at this percent. Look at it. Look at his percent for Lucario. That is rage. That is, you got a little bit of aura. Would I be able to tell you how aura works? Not totally, but
big number is scary. That's how aura works.
Yeah, big number go brr. And then also, what I think is really important is take a look at Nixie's percent, 153. Your legend vulnerability runs out. So not only do you have access to one of the biggest, most absolutely menacing projectiles, this thing is huge. It hits you when it charges. You know what else does that? Nothing.
Nothing.
It's one of a kind in this game.
They should have made Mewtwo's do it.
I know, that would have been so sick. So you got this menacing, like, ball of death coming at you. You got all this percent on you. You run out of legend vulnerability, so you're forced to drop down, and you're gone. You got nothing else. All of your options are whittled away.
Truly, one of the only ways Nixie could have gotten away with that is if he get up attacked the Aura Sphere. That's like one of the only things he could have done, but that's
and it was a
regrab
too. So, yeah. Regrabs are a little bit funky because on the first regrab, you still actually have access to some invuln, I believe, on like get up attack and some stuff. Would I be able to tell exactly how it works? No. The properties are different between the first regrab and the second one.
Yeah.
And it's a little bit different if you already had gone out of legend vulnerability. There's a lot of factors to consider. Basically,
it was scary. It was scary for Nixie.
He was Dunskies.
Yes. And right here, we're going to have, coming up, we're going to have Zomba versus...